Hello, welcome to the Security Insights video. Today we're going to take a look at the new Security Insights that we've added to Lansweeper. Obviously, as you might know, we've been providing customers with a lot of security related news and data already. Lansweeper customers can use all the data that we provide on Lansweeper, all the small details about their IT network environment to increase and manage their cybersecurity. But now we're taking it a step further and we're going to provide actual security insights in the platform itself and provide you with the vulnerability data inside of the platform itself. So let's take a look inside of Lansweeper and see what it's like. So here we are on the Lansweeper cloud dashboard. The security insights are only available on the cloud platform where we're able to integrate with the vulnerability data that we pull from our source. And as you might tell, there is a new tab here available called Security Insights. So let's head over there. And we're instantly greeted with all of the active vulnerabilities within our own environment. So these go back quite a long way, but they are vulnerabilities that we've been able to match to data within your specific environment. So to take a look, we're going to go over to this Firefox vulnerability, where we see we get a nice overview of all of the vulnerability information, like the general description, the CVSS score that it has received, as well as links and references to the official sources, so you can take a look at more additional data if you want to see it. Now, if you actually want to know which assets are affected, we have an assets tab where you can head over to and it'll list all of the assets where we found that there are still vulnerable to this specific vulnerability, which means that you can start taking action on these specific devices, and as they get updated, as you mitigate the vulnerability, they'll start disappearing from the list as well. Obviously, if you just want to take a look at any of these devices, you can simply click on them and it will hyperlink to that specific device where you can see all of the specific data on that device, including, in this case, we have a software vulnerability, so we can actually head over to the software tab and actually verify that if we find a Firefox version here, that it is lower than that specific version that has the fix in it. As you might have seen, this feature also carries the preview tag, so we are still working on it. We're still enhancing it, adding additional functionality to make it even more useful for you in the future. With that, I want to thank you for watching this Security Insights video and see you next time.